Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollotech, and Apple released iOS 16.1 Beta 3 to developers, and iOS 16.1 Public Beta 3 should be very soon. This came in at 712 megabytes on my iPhone 14 Pro Max and was about the same size on all the devices here. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 16 Beta 10, along with macOS 13 Beta 9, watchOS 9.1 Beta 3, also tvOS 16.1 Beta 3, and HomePod OS 16.1 Beta 3. All of those are available now. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, General, then About, and you can see the build number is 20B5056E. This particular build does have some updates and changes in them, so let's go ahead and talk about them. But first, this does have a modem update in it, so if you were having connectivity issues, whether that be with the newer phones or older phones, you should see some sort of modem update. Now the first change is under Settings, and then if we go to our wallpapers, they've updated the UI for this. You'll see initially or immediately, you'll see a new UI for this where we have a Add New Wallpaper button, and we can also see all of our different wallpapers we've set in the past with a nice little sort of animation as we swipe through them, and then a Set as Current button. So we have all of those options now. We can just swipe through them, or we can add new ones here and just easily add them. They continue to improve this overall. And one thing I noticed right away is if we set a new wallpaper, it seems to be very fast. So if we press the plus button, maybe we'll just set the weather wallpaper, we'll hit add, hit set wallpaper pair, and then we're done. So it seems to be much faster than it was before, and that's a great improvement. Now also, if we go into our settings, there's a new update here. So in settings, then if we go down to App Store, under App Store, you'll see we have an in-app content option. If we go under settings and then App Store here, let's turn on dark mode. This is on beta 2. You'll see we do not have an in-app content option. So it says automatically run apps in the background to download content before you first launch them. So you now have that option. It's turned on by default. On the iPad, Apple has updated something people have wanted for a while on some devices. So many people have been wanting Stage Manager, and now it's available on iPads Pro 3rd and 4th Gen from 2018 and 2020, along with the M1 iPad. So if we go into settings, you go down to home screen and multitasking, you'll now have a Stage Manager option. You can turn that on or off and use it how we've been using it on the M1 iPads all along. Now, Apple made a statement to Mac Rumors, and you'll see here that they said, "We introduced Stage Manager as a whole new way to multitask with overlapping resizable windows on both the iPad display and a separate external display, with the ability to run up to 8 live apps on screen at once. Delivering this multi-display support is only possible with the full power of M1-based iPads. Customers with iPad 3rd and 4th generation have expressed strong interest in being able to experience Stage Manager on their iPads. In response, our teams have worked hard to find a way to deliver a single screen version for these systems, with support for up to 4 live apps on the iPad screen at once. External display support for Stage Manager on M1 iPads will be available in a software update later this year." And so one thing I noticed right away is when I plugged in an external display, it didn't seem to work other than with screen mirroring. So we can screen mirror, but I wasn't able to have it extend anymore. So I'm not sure if it's a different setting, they've moved it, but I wasn't able to get that to activate in our display settings or anything like I was on earlier betas of iPad. So if you wanted to use that, you may want to consider not upgrading for a little while until Apple updates it later on. Now again on the iPhones, if we go into settings and then we scroll down and go to general, Apple has actually removed Matter accessories from beta 3. So there's no longer a settings option for it, but the overall capabilities are still there on the iPhone, but the settings is gone. So they've removed that for now. Maybe it'll come back later on. Apple's also updated the focus modes. So if we go back into settings and then go over to our focus modes, you'll see under focus, if we add a new focus, we'll add one here. It's a little hard to reach on these plus size phones. You'll see maybe we'll add a fitness focus. They've changed the graphics for almost every one of these, where they've changed what it looks like. So under driving, you'll see they've updated that. And then we'll go to gaming. Again, they've updated it. And then mindfulness with a new graphic. And then under personal, again, a new graphic there, reading, and then of course work here as well. So all of those have been updated under focus modes. Now, satellite connectivity is actually present in the code here, but I wasn't able to sort of activate this in any sort of way. You'll see under SOS or emergency SOS, technically the code is there to allow you to connect via satellite. I tried on different phones, the 13 Pro or the 14 Pro rather, and the 14 Pro Max, and was not able to get it to activate. Now it may be only available in certain areas, but hopefully we'll be able to test this soon. But it looks like that satellite connectivity that Apple promised with the 14 Pro Max and the 14 Pro and 14 series is coming later on, but with 16.1. Also something worth mentioning is live activities for sports seems to be working since beta 2. So under TV, we saw some of that there. If you go into a live sports option here, let's see if we can get this to load, and you'll see we have a game here. It says live. If you have the option to follow, you can follow it, and then it will show on your lock screen and give you updated real-time scores with your live activities. So that's something that they added with beta 2. It's showing up for many people if you want to follow certain sports games. It doesn't seem to work on all things yet, but hopefully it will be soon. And then of course live activities is available for developers with 16.1. Also, one thing to note is some people are saying that the battery icon looks slightly different as far as its overall roundedness. I see it slightly, maybe the actual corners are slightly more round, but some people were pointing it out, so I thought I'd mention it here. Now, many have mentioned that YouTube picture-in-picture seems to be fixed. So where there was an issue before, let me turn down the volume. We'll go into my channel, play one of my videos. Now it's playing, we'll swipe home, and it loads right away. Before, it sort of was just a blank screen and then it wouldn't work. So you'll see here it's loaded, it's working, and it's actually playing. So it's working properly. If I swipe it off to the side, it's working as you would expect. So that's a good sign. It's working if you have that available. Also, the startup sound seems to be working. Where it wasn't working for me before in betas, turning it off and turning it back on seems to work with beta 3. So if we turn this off, so we'll turn it back on, give it a moment. There we go. It turns on, gives us the sound. It wouldn't do that for me before. Now, also a couple things worth noting is the music album artwork animation still seems to be that same sort of glitchy bug. So if we go and play a song, we'll turn down the volume here, play a song, we'll swipe home. And if we go to the lock screen, you'll see here, if I tap on the album art, it just jumps in. And now if I tap on it again, it bounces up and down again. This is something that doesn't seem very smooth. We had thought they'd fix by now, but continues to be an issue. So it may be an issue for some. Also, the storage bug seems to be not really there anymore, but some people are complaining of excessive storage being used. Again, I wanted to just sort of reiterate, I wouldn't worry about it too much unless you're out of storage altogether. So if we go into storage, you'll see this is a 512 gigabyte model. Give it just a moment to load. System storage seems to be taking up a good amount of data, but that's okay. I have a ton left. So as long as it's not taking up to the point where you can't maybe take photos, videos, or install apps, it's not a problem. You'll see it's using 31.87 gigabytes, and this will just change over time. It's system cache overall, and I wouldn't really worry about it, but let me know if it's an issue for you. As far as the latest phone, some people are reporting issues with the display. Now, in the past, we've had issues with green tint and even red tint, and if we put the brightness down very low, in the dark parts of the display, some people said they experienced flickering. I haven't seen this, but I'd love to hear if you're having this issue in the comments below. Now, as far as the overall release notes, let's go ahead and take a look at those. We'll go into feedback, and you'll see here, if we go into this, most of these are just Matter accessory issues. So they've resolved an issue where you might be unable to pair using a Matter ECM code via the Matter Support Framework Pairing API. That's been fixed, but there's still known issues as far as Matter goes. So you'll see you might receive an alert to turn on Wi-Fi when pairing a Matter accessory, and other issues here. That memory allocation issue I mentioned with beta 2 is still here, and there's pretty much no other things mentioned here. So they definitely are fixing some issues, but there's still more to be fixed, mostly due to Matter accessories. And there must be something a little bit more difficult about this, but we are expecting new HomePods. Maybe they're waiting for some things like that next year. But again, we're waiting for Matter to be the standard. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 16.1 beta 3, I would say if you're on beta 2, then absolutely. If not, I would probably hold off and stay on 16.0.2. I wouldn't try and resolve an issue by going to this beta, as it's a little unknown as how it's going to perform. It will take a few days to know that. As far as iOS 16 beta 4's release, At this point, we can expect weekly updates until the final release. I would expect beta 4 or beta 5, maybe beta 4 a release candidate, and then beta 5 in mid-October or so. Then we'll hear about iPadOS releasing to the public, as well as macOS Ventura. We're expecting those along the lines of a new iPad and maybe new Macs as well. However, we may not have an October event, as some people are saying, just to expect it in a press release. So we'll have to wait and see, but I would expect something in mid-October as far as iOS 16.1. As far as overall performance, well, performance seems to be quite good so far. Of course, it will take time to know that for sure. ProMotion on the latest devices seems to be nice and fast. And like I said, wallpaper, at least setting the wallpaper, seems to be much faster than before. And benchmarks also show that it's pretty fast in general. So if we go into our benchmarks, under Geekbench, I ran this right after installing it, but I scored 1,899 for single core, 5,371 for multi-core. If we go into the history, you'll see on the previous beta, it's faster by a little bit for single core and a little bit faster for multi-core as well. Over 100 faster for multi-core. So it seems to be performing well so far. And of course, Apple will continue to optimize for performance and battery life as we go on. As far as battery life goes, well, it takes a few days to measure that, but we'll take a look. I've been testing the 14 Pro just so I can do a full review on it. I like to use them for a full week before I know what it's like, or at least some. My wife has one as well we can look at. But you'll see battery health and charging, 100%. And then if we go down to the last 3 days, you'll see I've been using it. The second day, which was fairly intensive, I only had 3 hours and 59 minutes of screen on time, 9 hours and 17 minutes of screen off time for some reason, and used 75% of my battery. Today, we're at 2 hours and 54 minutes of screen on time and 5 hours of screen off time at 50% of the battery. So of course, this is no Pro Max. It's not going to get incredible battery life, but so far it's getting me through the day, but filming this video, we're down to 43%. And so that's everything we know so far about iOS 16.1 Beta 3. Of course, if I find anything else, I'll have a follow-up about that. And let me know if you want weekend follow-ups, as I typically don't do those at this time of year. Normally I'm focused on hardware, but if you'd still like to see those on the weekend, let me know in the comments below. Of course, if you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.